Hello everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome one and all. Welcome back if you are coming back to the channel. Welcome if you're new. Howdy doody. So, today I am starting a new series of sorts. And this is based on the fact that I am, well, those of you who have been watching my videos know that I am very, very new to anime. I recently was introduced to Attack on Titan. And, you know, this series just literally has blown my mind. And we're going really well. We're into season two of it. It got me thinking. Damn, there's got to be some other, you know, mind-blowingly good animes out there. So, what I'm thinking of doing, guys, and let me know if you like the idea, is I'm thinking of watching openings for each of the different series, and then seeing if we're gonna like what, you know, seeing if we like what we see, and then making reactions to those series. You know, so for example, if we like us, if we watch an opening and the series looks good, then maybe start a series based on it. So I thought that would be a good idea. And the one we're going to do today is actually one that someone, my friend, recommended to me. That this is the same friend that recommended Attack on Titan. I said, right, Attack on Titan's amazing. Tell me another one. And they said, JoJo's Bizarre Adventures. So now. Again, like with Attack on Titan, I know absolutely nothing. Not a zip, nothing. Ninguno. However you want to say it. I know nothing. And I'm really excited to watch this video and see if it's something that I would like to continue with. Because apparently it is a very damn good anime series. So, without further ado. Let's go see all of the openings to JoJo's Adventure. And rather weirdly, it's called openings 1 to 9.99 instead of like 1 to 10. Very strange. Hoping that maybe they'll explain that. Or we'll see that in the video. Anyway, I've babbled on long enough. Let's just go and watch the introductions. See you there, guys. So, got my logo. Let's get into it, guys. And what the plan is to. To stop and reflect at the end of each one. You know, obviously we're going to talk through it, but to reflect after each one as well. So, let's go. Wow. That's a very enthusiastic entrance. It's immediately caught my attention. Wow, I love the artwork. It's brilliant. And it's constantly spinning, not keeping still. So colourful. Lady, it's amazing. Oh, and a kiss as well. All right. Oh, it's just not staying in one place. It's brilliant. I like it. And 3D style as well. Don't have 3D glasses, unfortunately. Wow. Oh my God. I mean, this is a little bit freaky, but it's also very good. Look, the animation is brilliant. And then it's like into a manga style, comic book style. It's like a brilliant mix. Wow. I'm liking this, guys. I really am. Is it like some like based on some kind of like superheroes or something? Wow, it's like very determined. And then he's just like a creepy guy. And then back to the manga. Oh my God, I can't stop talking. Wow. And then it's like the clash. I guess one of those two is JoJo. Wow, guys, that was pretty damn good, I must say. Considering that was my first, introduction to JoJo, I must say I'm a little bit impressed. It is enticing me to definitely come and watch this series. I liked all of the mixture of the manga type pictures with the 3D images, and then the music was so upbeat. JoJo, JoJo, you know, it's in my head. I just don't think that's going to go away. All right, so on to the second one. Wow, that's catchy as well. This one's like completely different. This one seems like a little bit different, a little bit more mellow, and it's just so damn colorful. Look at it, colors all over the place, and you know, nothing standing still. It's brilliant. And I like the outlines actually this time. You know, it's completely different from the first one, where the first one you had the full 3D pictures, and then these ones are all outlined. And you're still getting the same impression, the same joy from it. And then, oh, hello, lady, with the long hair and no clothes. Okay, so is this like a love story of some sort then? Because it's like a heart, keep a hand, trying to grab love. Oh my, that was a bit freaky. It's so catchy. I mean, that's what you want from an introduction. It's so catchy. I mean, that's why Game of Thrones is just so damn good. I mean, you know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of like an RPG. You know, you got the villains, and then you got all these people, all the characters. I mean, is this JoJo? Don't know. Maybe, I think I've said this is JoJo like 4 times. I don't know. Okay, there's whatever that is. Whatever that object is, I think it's going to be very centric to the series. Well, to series number 2. And yeah, as I was saying, this just reminds me of like Persona 5. That was what I was looking for. Persona 5. It just reminds me of this. I believe that's actually based on a manga. I'm not entirely sure. And you can tell because, you know, it's like anime-like. But damn. This is... I don't know what to say. I'm really enjoying it. Apart from that, I'm really enjoying it. The contrast between those first 2 seasons was like night and day in some ways. You know, the first one was very, very, very upbeat. All the characters, 3Ds, and the second one is a little bit more mellow. You got the shadows. It seems like you saw the villain. I don't know, it's looking pretty damn good, and I'm getting enticed to definitely come and watch this. So, let's get to number 3, shall we? Alright. Okay, this one's a bit more keyboardy, guitar-y, this one. Oh, I keep seeing these, like, people and then, like, shadows keep popping up. Oh, it's like a guitar solo. Again, this one's like, this is completely different, like, to the other ones. This one's like a guitar-y type. So, I mean, from what I can gather here, we got characters, and they seem to have like ghosts that appear from them. I don't know, I mean, this introduction seems to be showing more of like the story than the others have been. Because we got to see like different characters all over the place. Like it seems like they're forcing like some sort of shadow to appear for them, like a Pokemon in a way, but obviously not a Pokemon. Is that based on like is it based on like cards then? So they have cards, and these cards transform them. I do like this guitar solo though. The guitar is just, oh, it's getting me pumped, man. Wow. So we've had 3 openings so far, and each one has just been completely different. Each one's been, drawn and shown in a different way. And, you know, from what I can gather, the main characters, and they all seem to be holding like cards or something, and then they like seem to be able to summon like shadows. So maybe the shadows fight or something. I'm not entirely sure again because I haven't really watched much anime. Attack on Titan was pretty much my first venture into it since Pokemon. So I'm definitely being enticed by this. The music is good. The opening sequences, they're so colourful. So enjoyable to watch. I just don't want to skip. You know, a lot of the times you find openings, you just want to skip them. But not these. No, not at all. I just want to go. So I'm going to the fourth one now, guys. Wow, this one again. This one again. this is completely different. And this one, I'm getting like the sense that this series is a bit more darker, slower, and they're building up a tempo. So this one's a bit more rocky. Yeah, a bit more like heavy metal, rocky type. And yeah, again with the shadows. What I'm liking about this is it's not really offering any kind of spoiler. You know, I'm not able to deduce what the hell's going on from all these animations and things. So yeah, there's again with the person and the shadow behind them. Okay, it's a bit faster now. I like it. Dun, 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 dun. Wow, I like it, man. It's going very well. And then at the end, the like they're all fighting to one common goal or something. It's definitely piquing my interest, guys. Ooh. Wow, what an introduction. Do 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 do. Dun, 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 dun. It's like they're all sort of trying to speak over each other. Oh, and then, wow, that's going really fast. Wow. I like this, very upbeat. Is that a dog? I mean, I just love the color of these introductions. There's just so much, and there's so much going on that I honestly don't know what to think. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, well, that was new. The hell? That was different. Or is that like the good guy and the bad guy passing by or something? The fight of good and between the fight between good and evil. I actually think I paused that a little bit early. I think that I paused it before the last one ended. Okay, this one's back to like the first one. It's like an 80s superpower film or TV series. Okay, this one's a bit different. This one's actually got people like walking in the street. I mean, there's just color everywhere. And they're weird openings. Okay, so everyone's got a character. This is what we're establishing here. I'm just so curious as to what the actual storyline of this is. And the music's just so upbeat. It's like dun, 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 dun. Wow, that was a very upbeat introduction. I don't know if that's season 4 or season 5. I think it was season 4. But damn, very, very good. I'm loving this. I actually do want to watch this now because the animation's brilliant, but just by watching this is making me go, okay, who's this guy? What's this guy? Well, what does that mean? You know, why are they doing that? What are these shadows? Why is everything so colourful? You know, I want to watch this. I want answers to all of these questions. So, next one. Or is this the same one? Okay, so, I mean, it seems like this is the same one. So, are they like part one, part two of a series? And each part's got like its own type of music? Yeah, this one's definitely a little bit different to the first version we saw. But it's the same animation, so I am. The only thing I can think of at the minute is part one, part two. That guy didn't have a shadow last time. The little boy. This one now reminds me of like Eastern European pop music. Something you would see at Eurovision. Something you would hear at Eurovision. But I love it. I love it. I love that kind of music. Brilliant. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Oh, okay. Very rocky, very fast. Okay, I'm getting the feeling that this guy, who's always first, the one with the blue hair, he's JoJo, I'm guessing. He's like my sixth or seventh guess. I'm sure I'll get it eventually. Just say he's JoJo to every character. Yeah. I love how JoJo seems to be inscripted everywhere. And then they just bring it into the next animation using the JoJo. He must be JoJo, this guy. I love the hairstyle. And that must be the evil guy. So he's reaching out, and then the evil guy turns, and it closes onto his eye. Whoa! This is totally different. Do, 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 do. It seems right. It seems that every single one of these is like a reflection of different times in history. Like the different music reflecting of the different time in history. So is this like a time series that they go backwards and forwards in time? Like they're time travelers? Is that what this is all about? Because I'm getting an impression, because each series has a different musical theme that for me represents like an era of time. Anyway, let me know. Oh, this one's sung in English. Yeah, this guy's definitely JoJo. Right, finally, JoJo. Don't know who he is though. He must be the villain. Rocky Land. This one seems like they're wearing like 60s type clothing. I love it. And just the animations, the silhouettes, and then all those silhouettes going into one to show you the character. That's cool. And then there's that JoJo theme again with a heart. It always seems to be a heart. Is that the logo? Well, obviously this is the logo, but the heart? Is that like a representation of the logo? And then again, we've got the same one again. See, let's see if it's any different. Oh, yeah, that's different. Oh dear. That's his justice, right? So, what are they fighting for justice for? This is very different. Seems like everything's been reversed. So any kind of achievement that happened in the first half has been reversed here in the second. I love the music though. So catchy. JoJo. But everything's been reversed. So all of the hard work that's previously been done. Ah, Ducky Land. And then Justice again. So it just seems to me like they're fighting for justice of some kind, obviously. And that the heart is at the center of it. Alright, where are we now? This is number 7, I think. Oh, I like this one. I liked all of them, really. It's just the animation, the drawings. They're just so good. Oh, I like this. That reminds me of James Bond. Oh, it's a sunglass. Sunglasses usually represent loss of, lack of time. So like some kind of timer, time limit. So maybe they have a time limit? He looks very bad. Oh god. Uh oh, that looks dangerous. And then what is going on here, man? I think this is the strangest one of them all. But also the best drawn or designed, however it's done, is a 3D computer, because it's brilliant. And then one side against the other, good against evil. Although, I didn't see the JoJo. Does JoJo change? Is JoJo a person? Or not a person? Is that the theme? What? Maybe JoJo is not a person. Huh. Interesting. I don't know. Hypothesizing again. Oh my god, that guy was fat and creepy. Wow, that is really well done with the zip. And then the arm breaking? What the hell, man? See, it just keeps getting me intrigued without revealing anything. I am none the wiser from I was in the first one. But I want to know all of this. Like a tragic turn. Blood. Blood's never good. He looks evil. Wow, that was like an amalgamation of all of them at the end there. So far, like an Arrow, JoJo, Golden Wind. I think this is the last one, maybe? Or is this a repeat? It looks like it might be a repeat of the last one. Yeah, and again, different. So it leads me to the theory that each series has two parts. And the music's different again. It's just so good. The drawings. Although the actual animation is the same, so they've just changed the music for this one. So far, anyway. Oh, what the hell? Shit. That's different. That's very different. It's like end of the world scenario. Good guys against, are they fighting themselves? The blood summoning some kind of monster? I can't make heads or tails who's good or bad in this. I do love the music though. It's da, 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 da. Hell no! Wow, they look scared. Something, it's like, that seems like it's end of the world-esque. Man, they're having to save the world. That's what it seems, anyway. Again? Or is this one different? No, it's the same one again. So is this like, I don't know, is JoJo finished? Is it finished as a series? And then this is the final part? Golden Wind. Not really seeing much different in this one here. Oh, we got the boom again. Yeah, the same line that was said. This guy must be like the big bad. This guy with the pink hair. What does this blood signify? Why is he bleeding? Like he's been like a little cut. Maybe it's for the spear that he needs to defeat the evil. Oh shit, that was violent. Oh, these monsters look a lot bigger. They actually look like monsters, like titans. Wow. Alright guys, wow, that was an experience, I must say. It was different. I really enjoyed the music, but what impressed me most about that was the openings. They were so enthralling, so they're just dragging you in, and the transitions in each section, like, you know, there was an instance where the zip on the face changed and the character came down, and then all of a sudden we moved to another part. Like that, like so fluid. So if the series is anything like that, it would be great. And I think, you know, after watching that, it's got me so intrigued as to what the hell it's about. Because I have no idea. And I've just watched 9 seasons worth of openings. and, you know, it seemed, because some of them repeated with like little tweaks, whereas others were just, we saw them just the one time. So it's got me thinking that maybe some of the seasons have been broken into 2 parts and then the last one into 3. And then you can see the little tweaks in the intro probably representing what happened in the first part. Let me know if that is the case. Obviously no spoilers, because I think I'm going to go and watch this. I really do. Because it was, you know, completely enthralling. I didn't really like the second one that much. But I think that was just because the first one, maybe it was just because the first one was so good. The first one grabbed my attention so much that I think it would have been very difficult to beat that. But it was, you know, like I was saying, it seems like each one is taken from a different period. The music, there was the pop, the rock, the indie pop, and then felt like it was in the 60s. And it feels like a time traveling thing. I mean, like I said, guys, I have no idea at all what this series is. These are just hype, you know, theories. I'm probably completely way off the mark, so don't hate me, you know. Yeah guys, I'm definitely gonna go and watch this, I think, and I'll put them here onto the channel. I'll react to them for everybody to see. And so check them out, guys, if you want to. And I'm also going to do more of these series. Obviously, don't want to do too many right at once because, there's only so much time in the day. People have to work. But yeah, so thank you, guys. Thank you very much for finding this. If you have stayed this long, thank you. Listening to all of my ramblings. And I will see you in the first episode of this whenever I do it. And thank you very, very much for watching. Don't forget to hit that like, that subscribe. I do daily reactions. So thank you very much, guys. And I will see you whenever we do this. Bye.